I promise there won't be any boys.
You're excused, Susan.
But Mrs. Donovan, please, I'm
Look waiting. On the bright side, dear. You may not have gotten the job, but think what fun you'll have telling your friends what a bitch Vera Donovan is. Next.
I've been working since I was 13 years old. Started out at the Devereaux Hotel housekeeping. By the time I left there in high school, I was cleaning three floors all by myself. I took care of my father's house after my mother passed on. I married and have a daughter. This is a big house, but I'm a big woman and I think I can do a good job.
I do not pretend to be an easy woman to work for. Dolores. This house has a number of rules. I'm sure you've heard them secondhand, but I'll tell you in person so we can avoid a teary scene later on. I like all the windows open every day for at least 2 hours.
And she did have her ways, did she ever? And fresh flowers. I don't know where she got her ideas, but I do know she was a prisoner of them.
The silver has to be checked and, of course, cleaned every week. It may look clean to you, but I like to see my face in it.
The tubs had to be scrubbed out every day with vinegar and baking soda. Tablecloths, napkins, handkerchiefs, everything hand-washed, ironed, and starched. Mildew was grounds for firing. But the sheets now, that was one thing you didn't ever want to get wrong. You could have cut off a high-flown, snobbish nose, and she still would have been able to smell a sheet that had hung outside from one baked in the dryer.
Do that now?
Talk to the missus.
Her husband, Jack. He only came up once all summer, most of which he spent ignoring her anyway. She could have just as easy had the clothesline beside the house. Not Vera Donovan. No, ma'am. She had to have the south wind blowing through her linens, and that meant tramping up and down that hill twice a day when it was fair.
Isn't this glorious, Jack? Dolores, you know that's the way I like it. Six pins, not five. Jack, it's 4:30. Don't you want a cocktail?
It was three square meals of bitchery all summer long, but I kept my head down and my mouth shut because every week that $40 went in the bank. There wasn't a damn thing she could say about it.
Thanks, Annette.
Much as she crabbed that whole summer, I must have done something right. It's come Labor Day.
Dolores, I'm sure your winter schedule's rather hectic, but I need someone to touch up the house once a week. Dusting, keeping the mice company.
I could do that for you.
$12 a week was what I had in mind.
That'd be fine.
And I'll see you next Memorial Day.